get to heaven, I won't have to slow down. I just want to keep on going. Hey. Keep on praising God. That's what it's all about. I guess when I think of the resurrection, think that our Lord died, we could have salvation. I think of all the years that I wandered through this world without God. Sometimes I wonder how I made it without God at my side. No one to pray to, no one to answer my prayers, no one to worship, really. Had no desire to be in the house of God, no desire to listen to this song to China. It thrills my heart, it thrills my soul, just to be in the house of God, to worship God. I trust that you would pray this morning that God would visit with us, that God would touch some hearts, lost souls. If there was words to say, and sometimes they're just not words, I guess the most difficult time is when there's a death in the family. You have to go to be with that family. It seems like there's just not words. There's just not words that you can really say. This won't come out. There's just something about it. It's that way when you really try to explain what God has done, what God is doing, what God can do in a person's life. You'll turn that life over to God. And it's hard for me to relate. It's almost impossible for me to reach down inside my heart. God said it's a joy unspeakable for the glory. My heart's filled with joy unspeakable. I just can't explain it to you. I just wish I had words that I could get it out where you could understand the joy that's down inside. Now, if you've been birthed in the family of God, you know what joy is, and you know the joy of salvation. But to a lost and a dying world today, those people have never experienced salvation. But not know what the joy of God can be in their heart and soul. I didn't know. I had no idea of joy that God could fill a heart, fill a soul. I know at this time of year it brings us close to maybe our family. We visit our family, and maybe the other times we don't visit and see people that maybe for a year we haven't seen. It brings maybe you close together. That's what God is doing. He's bringing a family close together. It's all because of the resurrection. Without the resurrection, there's no hope. Tonight we'll try to deal with that blessed hope that we have. This morning I want to give you some thoughts about, has anyone seen Jesus? Has anyone seen Jesus? God hung upon a cross at Calvary almost 2,000 years ago, or 2,000 years ago thereabouts. Christ hung between heaven and hell to pay the sin debt that we, as individual people, could have a way of escape. He did that because he loved us. After he hung up on the cross at Calvary, in our sunrise service this morning, we brought some thoughts about the cross and how Christ hung upon that cross and the seven sayings that he uttered from the cross and the meaning. They had a certain meaning. God wanted the world to know that he was dying for the sins of the whole world. And then we brought Christ through the Word and we brought him to a place where he has been resurrected. After the resurrection of our Lord, we can look back now and we can see an empty cross and we can see an empty tomb. Yet we know that Christ is seated at the right hand of God. But we find through the Scriptures that God revealed himself after the resurrection. You remember as he walked on the earth, he told time after time after time to his disciples, I must die, I must be placed in a tomb, and after the third day, I will be resurrected. They did not understand that. Their ears were deaf to God speaking to them, and they could not understand what he was saying. So after the death, the burial, and then the resurrection comes, and God appeared to many people through the Word of God to reveal to you and I that we can read back through the Word, and I believe this to be God's inspired Word of God. I believe God gives this Word of God to you and I that we can have an understanding about what he has accomplished what we can have for our lives. And as we read through the scriptures, we find several places that God appeared to many people as individuals, give those individuals certain instructions for their lives, where you and I can read and find those instructions for their lives, apply those instructions to our lives, and see what God is trying to teach us through the Word of God. Now, there was a very great purpose for God revealing himself as he walked here on this earth. A tremendous purpose that we find through the Word of God. You remember, many did not believe. The Sadducees said, well, there's no such thing as a resurrection. They will not believe in a resurrection. Today, there are thousands of people that do not believe in a resurrection, a literal resurrection of a Savior. Many people today are dying and going to hell because they do not believe in the resurrection of the Lord. God made the plan of salvation very simple. God said, if we would believe in our heart that God has raised him from the dead, that's the resurrection. If we'll believe that, and we'll trust in that, and we can see the resurrected God or the resurrected Savior, God said, you can be saved. You can be birthed in the family of God. And for years, I could not see that. God did not quicken my mind. He did not have the Spirit of God to convict me. And I did not see for so many years that I was lost and undone. Before a person can be saved, they got to recognize that they're lost. You can never be saved until God opens your eyes and you recognize the fact that you're lost. You may have good moral standards. You may have a good reputation in the community. You may have religion. But without recognizing that you're lost and without God and recognizing that you need a Savior, never come to the place of the saving knowledge of God. God said, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And now in the Word, very plain, that we have all sinned. He said, there's no good, no not one. So there's no point of you and I trying to come to the place where we are perfect before we are saved, because we'll never reach that place in life. God wants you just as you are. We sing the song, just as I am. And we find that we must come to the place and we recognize that we're lost. And then we must recognize that it was God. They provided the way. God provided the plan. God bent the Word of God down that we could have a way of an escape from those sins that we're loaded down with. That was by the Lord Jesus Christ hanging upon the cross at Calvary. And then being placed in a tomb. And then on the third day, seeing the resurrection of our Lord. In the Bible, in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, we'll read the first few verses of this chapter to give a jumping off place to see that God has revealed himself to many during the course of his resurrection. Now Christ is still in the process of revealing himself to many today. We're going to find in biblical days, in the days that Christ was resurrected, that he appeared to many, and maybe some of the reasons that he appeared, and then we'll apply it to an application for today, and then I trust. If you have never been birthed, truly birthed into the family of God, I beg with you, listen to this message this morning. I plead with you, listen to the Word of God. God said, faith comes by hearing the Word of God. You must hear the Word of God. That Word must settle in your mind, in your heart, in your soul. And then you can come to the saving knowledge of our Lord and our Savior. So you listen to the Word of God as we bring the message this morning, and I think it'll be helpful to you. God chose out the foolishness of preaching. This is God's method, not mine. I was very content in the other way, but God said, I want you to preach the Word of God. And sometimes it's very nerve-wracking to stand and preach the Word of God, especially when you're trying to do it yourself. You need the power of Almighty God to preach the Word of God. So you listen as the Word of God goes forward, that you might come to the saving knowledge of God. Because, as we mentioned this morning in the cemetery,